that defeat to Tunisia in September of 2021. So an important game for qualification. Tunisia, two defeats already. Unusual for them. So they've already been beaten twice in qualification. It means this is an important game. A defeat here against Egypt will make it a tough ask for them. Really put the pressure on for the remaining games. They will want to get back to the World Cup, a place where they were last time out. In 2019, unfortunately, they couldn't get about out of Group C, going down to Spain and Puerto Rico. So, teams out onto the floor. The white uniforms of Egypt, the red for Tunisia. The battle for North Africa then. Ready to get underway. Hello and welcome to Monastir. It is Egypt against Tunisia, off to a full start as the jump ball touched too early by Salem Ejri. That will give possession to Egypt to start us off here. First game for these two teams in round number two. They're in Group F. And the only opening possession for Egypt then. Man-to-man defense from Tunisia. Screens are set now. Salah trying to get some room, takes the three, and that is a great start for Ehab Salah. He makes the first one and gets Egypt off to a smooth start. Tunisia struggled for points in round number one against some of the better teams, and first possession rejected. Great work from Anas Mahmoud. He gives it up. Murai, that's his type of shot, makes it a strong start for Egypt. Both ends of the floor then. You can see the size in that front line for the Egyptians. Anas Mahmoud with the block. Marai with the finish. Abada trying to find some room. We'll pick up the first whistle of the afternoon as Farak commits the personal. Jump up, doesn't go. Offensive rebound, so Abada controls things. Wants the high screen. Good switching defense from Egypt, well organized. There's the drive, looking for Mejri. Can he finish? He can't. And rebound snatched in. Right. The multi-talented Mahmoud loses it on his way to the basket. Anas Mahmoud. Well, he is a unicorn. Can play every position on the floor. Got the size and the length of a centre. That likes to face up. Likes to put the ball on the floor. 5-0 start. Tunisia still searching for their first points. We said they really did struggle in round one. Just scoring the ball. Mitch Bauman has a chance to work with his team now. See if they get any better as Abada is fouled. Well, last time, Egypt so organized on that switch, same play. This time they weren't ready for it, and the first foul is called against Ehab Amin. Yeah, too late from Amin. Took a shot to the chest as well. See if he's okay. And we talked about the game last time these teams met in AfroBasket, and Amin, the leading scorer on that occasion for Egypt. Abadi finally gets his team off the mark. Two for two. He'll get three shots. As he was fouled, shooting beyond the three-point line. Smooth from Omar Abadah then. Pressure up the floor from Tunisia. Amin gets away from the defender. Marai now. Got to stay down on the fakes from Marai. There's the offensive rebound for Mahmoud. It really is a tough front line for Egypt. Marai in and around the basket. And you've got to come, you know, a lot of the time with the second defender to slow him down. Leaves Mahmoud free. Same play from Tunisia. Better defense again from Egypt as Abadah drives against Mahmoud. Taken away. Shot clock getting low. Ben Ramdan, the runner, too strong. And Marai snatches in the rebound. You can see the intensity in the early stages of this one. Egypt will reverse it round. Mahmoud to Marai. Said you've got to stay down on the fakes. Marai with some exquisite low post footwork that time. You know, struggled over the length of measure. The good work from the veteran big man. It is El Mabrouk bringing it down. Oh, nice little cut and feed. Ben Ramdan to Abadah. Two players that know each other well. Abadah all five for Tunisia here. Foul called against Ben Ramdan. Let's see our first substitution coming in. It's for Egypt. It's in the backcourt. So, Walid Ali coming in. Nice little pass from him that comes off the leg. No reset of the shot clock. End line possession. Egypt will have it. Shot clock still on 10. Plenty of time for them. Mahmoud in the low block. Tried to be aggressive, Egypt. I'm going to turn it over here, Abadah with the steal. But he loses it back. Shot clock hasn't reset. And Tunisia with the rebound. El Mabrouk, always under control, puts it on the floor. No more as a shooter than a driver. Draws the foul. A lot of words being had all around here. Complaints all round. So El Mabrouk will, I think, be awarded with two shots here. The foul's going to go against Ihab. I mean, well, no, surely not. I'm in. It is. It looked like that should be against Ali rather than Amin, but he's had to head to the bench as it has been judged to him. Yusuf Chihata comes in. And now Egypt will use the creativity of Mahmoud. He brings it down. Tries to find some room. Marai to Mahmoud. Five on the clock. Open three on the kick out. Misses badly. Didn't hit the ring. And shot didn't quite get up in time for Shusha. Good defense from Tunisia. And they have a chance to take the lead here. Abadah moving the pieces around. So Shanufi. Now El Mabrouk. El Mabrouk though. Pass too strong for him. He thinks he's being held. Egypt with possession once more. So that's Chihata. As Michael Roll gets the applause coming in. Ali handling the ball. That's a little bit of room. Nice pass. Murray, can he finish against two defenders? Can't on the first occasion. Gets it again. He's rejected from behind. Meshedi gets it clean and is down the floor early. Ben Ramdan, the kick out. Clean look for Abada. Doesn't go, but Meshedi on the offensive glass. Nearly loses it. Gets it back. Reverses it home. That is Tunisian basketball right there. Salah Meshedi. Great work from him. Mahmoud. The lefty three is good. Shihata makes it. Restores the Egyptian advantage. Marai. Speaking to the official, I think he's got some blood. Yeah, you can see it. Marai being warned about the way he's spoken to the official. You can see why he's complaining. He's got blood. He didn't get a foul call in the last possession. That's what he's saying. So he will head to the side. A lot of changes for Tunisia now. Oh, sorry, Egypt. Come deep into the bench. A lot of confusion as now. It's a foul. Tunisia trying to get it inbounds. Shusha commits it. He now goes out. Sideline possession again for Tunisia. Meshedi collects it, gives it to Roll. Michael Roll off the screen. Such a dangerous three-point shooter, Roll. To Elmerbrook. Elmerbrook sells the fake. Ben Ramdan with five on the clock. Got to go quickly. Down to two. Misses everything. Good defense from Egypt there. Abdel Nasser and some physical one-on-one coverage as the three is up. Back-to-back triples for Egypt. That is Abdul Halim knocking down his three. Oh. Mahmoud, the only man who started the game, still on the floor for Egypt, but they have a four-point advantage here. Roll, attacks with the left hand to Ben Ramdan. Now Meshedi. Meshedi likes to get the early three away. And the sighter goes for Salah Meshedi. Expect to see him take another one now. He made that. Good three-point shooting for both teams. Abdul Halim reverses. Mahmoud, his pass. Stopped by the right boot of Salah Meshedi. More substitutions. A round of applause for Abada who heads out. And Ganouni comes in. Ganouni, a scoring threat. Offensive foul, yeah, easy call. Not a smart play from Khalid Abdel Nasser. A moving screen from him. A lot of whistles in this first quarter. Egypt already in the boat, team fouls. Tunisia committed just one as Ben Ramdan gets his step. Meshedi said he'll take another one because he made the first and he's got his eye in early here. Salah Meshedi, 8 points personal for him. Nice screen from Mahmoud. Good defense from Tunisia. You know the scout well. Trying to keep Abdul Halim off his left hand. Mahmoud kicks it. Close out. And the rebound bounces to Michael Roll. Ben Ramdan to Roll. Roll thinks about the three, gives it to Ben Ramdan, a kick out open, and this is what he can do. The drive doesn't go. Ben Ramdan tips it home. And a rare miss for Ganouni. Ben Ramdan, as we've seen him do so often, cleans up the pieces for Tunisia, giving them the four-point lead here. Mahmoud runs into two defenders, has to spin away, loses his balance, and Tunisia rolling right now. Inspired by this home crowd, here's El Mabrouk into Meshri, the spin, the reverse, Salah Meshri lays it up for two, he's got double digits already. Tunisia with some momentum. What a run this is for the Tunisians. And we said Egypt had made a lot of subs early in this one. We might need to make some changes, bring those starters back again. In one stage it was 13-12, but a 7-0 run for Tunisia has given them this advantage now. Firas Lahani in for the first time for Tunisia. Kick out. Oh, a little hesitation before the shot. That's never a good sign. This Said misses. Sif Samir, sorry. Roll now. Sorry. Rolls on the far side as Meshri takes another one. Doesn't get it to go. Pull up jumper. Abdul Halim, he can't get it to go. It will stay with Egypt though. Is Michael Roll need to trouble the scorers as Meshri gets a good round of applause as he heads out. Not a first quarter for him. Again, a little hesitation before the three, no real rhythm to the shots from Egypt right now. Shahada, one of four, he misses that one. Roll, that's a rhythm shot. And it comes up short on this occasion. Sideline possession for Egypt. Abada playing some good pressure against Walid Ali. And Abdul Halim being forced away from that left hand, his skip pass, but couldn't hold on to the ball. And it's Samir just lost the handle. We hit 1 minute left in this first quarter. Still a 7-0 run continues for Tunisia. Roll. Kicks it, the three doesn't fall. Good rebound from Egypt. Chance to go for 2-for-1. Oh, that goes quickly here. Abdul Halim. Back it down against Abada. Double team comes from Roll. Smart from him. Who comes up with the ball? It's gone out and it's Tunisian possession. Great defense from the Tunisians there. Abada knew where he's sending the man. And Michael Roll ready on the rotation. So Kanouni goes out, some subs come back in. El Mabrouk, Meshri return for this last 28 seconds. Chance to, you know, get another score here, push that lead out even more for Tunisia. Abada backs it way out, uses the rescreen for Meshri, kicks it. Meshri looks to pass, now puts it on the floor, dances it inside to follow. Doesn't quite go. Third attempt, Meshri gets it to go. Last 5 seconds here. Can Egypt get one final shot away? Abdul Halim pulls up, but comes up short. Now the fans here in Monastir will be delighted with that response from their team. At a quarter time here, it is Tunisia at the 21-13 advantage over Egypt. Now we see the numbers. It looks like the Tunisia of old Inside-outside game working for them. Some of the highlights from that first quarter. It started off brightly for Egypt. A 7-0 run for them to start the game. After that, you can see the domination of Tunisia as they responded with a 21-6 run of their own, including their last 9 points. Salameshi led the way for them. 12 points for him, 5 of 8 shooting and 6 rebounds as well. You know, pretty solid numbers for the entire 40 minutes for Meshri in that first quarter alone. But Tunisia, he said, in the first round, they just didn't look like the Tunisian team we have come accustomed to seeing, the back-to-back Afrobasket champions. But this is Tunisia back to their best. And Coach Roy Rana, just to the left of the picture there, he will have to work for his team on the sideline here. Egypt trailing by 8 after the first 10 minutes. So smiles from two competitors that know each other well. Salameshi, a little kiss on the head for Marai. As we are underway in quarter number 2, Egypt, a lot of those starters back out onto the floor. So they need that front line of Mahmoud and Marai out there to try and compete with this Tunisian team. Roll looks for Meshri, and he lays it up for 2 more. Salameshi rolling back the years here. 14 points now for him. It is a double-digit game, 23-13. Egypt the one struggling for points. Mahmoud moves it on. Abdul Halim goes up high. Marai, he won't miss that opportunity. Ossam Marai gets the score. Mahmoud to roll. Roll. Oh, smart play. Just sold the fact he was going to use that high screen, defend a bit. And so he drove to the basket instead. Didn't convert the jump shot though. So Egypt, chance to cut to the lead more. Marai backing it in against Meshri. Pushes him out the way, goes to the jump hook. Have the touch though, also Marai. So often we see him make those. Mahmoud using the screen. Meshri made his first 2, misses that one. Mahmoud looking to push all the way. Oh, look at the reach. Anas Mahmoud just glides in for an easy 2. And great response out of this quarter break for Egypt then. They've made it now a 6-point game. Roll. Taking it deep, goes to Meshri. Salameshi for 3 is good. Salameshi, well, running out of words to say about him and his performance so far. 17 points now, 7 of 11 from the field. He's only played 10 minutes. Egypt with no answer right now. The kick out, Abdul Halim. His 3's too strong. Who else but Meshri grabs in the rebound. Abada. Meshri hands it off. And now Abadi will take one. Another 3 for Tunisia. Raining jumpers here. Yes, Abadi, who's been quiet, makes that one. The only man outside of Meshri to make a 3. Quick response for Egypt the other way. Mahmoud gives it up, gets it back again now, waits for Meshri to screen. Mahmoud will take one, too strong. Body's on the floor. That's Meshri down. Mahmoud as well. Meshri looks shaken up. Not sure what happened. Meshri seems to be okay. You can see Meshri's belief of what happened. Thought there was an elbow. There's no elbow there, though. Meshri just fell to the floor after taking a hit, pulled his man with him. So, let's see what happens here. Referee's going to go to the monitor. This could be an unsportsmanlike foul against Salah Meshri here. Right. He crumpled to the floor and just pulled Mahmoud down with him. I think that could be upgraded as an unsportsmanlike foul. So I'm sure he's an emotional character at times. So there's plays like this, you wonder if it is upgraded, how he'll respond in his past. Plays like this would have taken him sometimes out of the game. And when he's playing so well, Tunisia just want to keep riding the back of their big man. They've taken him out here. He's got 17 points. He's got 8 rebounds already. Incredible is he's not even played 12 minutes. So still looking at the replay. Not sure how long this will take. Then referees have got their verdict. Foul called against Salah Meshri, but a regular foul. So it'll be just a possession for Egypt. Unsportsmanlike. Looks at Tunisia up with this double-digit lead, a chance to bring the pressure up the floor. Back into the game for Egypt is Ahab Amin. Here he is with the ball. Amin, thought about the three. Whistle away from the ball, foul called against Tunisia. Sideline possession. All right, available. Turnover though. That's Tunisia. Have some open floor. They don't have numbers yet though. They'll steady themselves here. Ayaza gives it up to Abada. Now they'll organise. Ben Ramdan. But an offensive foul. Again, another whistle away from the ball. Didn't see that one. It's going to be caught against Gayaza. Stuttering start to quarter number two here. A lot of whistles. But for Tunisia, they maintain this double-digit lead. Taking some punches from Egypt, really. Still held firm. The three for Amin is good. Wow, that's an impressive shot. Walked into it. That is why he was the leading scorer the last time these two teams met. Ben Ramdan loses it off his own foot. And back-to-back possessions there for Egypt. Timeout called, 22 plays 29. Egypt trailing Tunisia right now. And Tunisia are going to call the timeout. Just regroup. It's See if we can listen in to Coach Dirk Bauman. Now, unfortunately, can't quite hear the Tunisian coach. There we see the numbers. 3-point shooting for both teams, relatively even. Good level as Egypt started to find that range. The rebounding battle tied as well. But still, the most important battle is the one on the right-hand side of the screen. And that's a 7-point advantage for Tunisia right now, thanks in a large part to Salah Mejri there. The left-hand side of the picture there, he is the number 50. What a game he is having, the former NBA player with the Dallas Mavericks. You see the numbers for him, 17 points, 8 rebounds, throw a block in there as well. Impressive numbers. Made for some big-time clubs as the 36-year-old. He's also won a host of medals for Tunisia at the AfroBasket Championships. You know, 3 times gold medalist, 2-time bronze medalist as well, and an MVP in 2011. Turnover for Egypt as they fail to inbound the ball. A great timeout for Tunisia then. They have possession here. Of movement as it comes into Ben Ramdan. Elmabrouk moves it on. Shanoufi for 3, too strong. Easy rebound for Egypt. Can they now chip away at this lead a little more? Mahmoud waiting, gives it up. Some confusion though of what Egypt are trying to achieve. In the end, they're going to have to take a tough 3. They fail to convert, and Tunisia come the other way. A bad up. Moves it over to Ben Ramdan. Ben Ramdan, tough pull up for him. Doesn't get it. Good work on the glass from Tunisia. Nearly kept it alive, but Egypt, a good job taking in the boards. Now Amin pulls up for 3. Doesn't get it. Marai was on the glass, but only succeeds in tipping it out last. Salah Mejri will come back in now after a short blow for Tunisia. And that will signal a timeout to be called by Egypt. Some work to be done on that sideline for the Egyptians. They trail by 7 here, 22-29. As we're at the midway point of the second quarter. Assistant turnover numbers for both teams there. As we see Coach Rana working that board for his team. Egypt yet to take a free throw in this game. And when you consider, you see the difference there, percentages-wise, from field goal range, not too dissimilar. But Tunisia have taken more shots, they've made one more. And then they've got an extra 5 free throws as well. So Egypt's got to find a way to be aggressive, put some pressure on Tunisia if they can. It's a veteran Tunisian team. You know, a lot of these guys, look at Mejri, 36 years of age. He's getting to the end of his career, but not only him. Michael Roll, 35. Ben Ramdan, 33. Gayaza, 35. Elmabrouk, 35 as well. Shanoufi has been out there, 33. There's a lot of guys with a lot of experience. And if you're Egypt, you know, is the one way to take away from that experience by trying to get them off the floor, lifting that tempo, getting them in foul trouble. So out of the timeout, Tunisia have possession. Abada controls it. Then she pops high. Now Abada on the far side. A lot of room for him and Mejri to work this two-man game. Oh, good hands. Mahmoud with the steal. Bullet pass ahead. Two Egyptian players nearly take each other out. In the end, Amin gets the score. 8 points for him. Abada looks up high, Mejri. Oh, easiest one he's had all night. Can't convert. Fight for the rebound. Falls eventually to Egypt. Now they've got some numbers in transition. Marai with space is fouled. Fourth team foul against Tunisia. It'll be end line possession for Egypt then. Any more after this one, it'll be shooting. Mabrouk sacrifices the personal, goes to the bench. As we see substitutions. Abada and El Mabrouk changes in that backcourt. El Mabrouk only one personal. No worries for him there. The drive, Marai, rejected by Mejri. Tunisia can't hold on to it though. The shot clock's been reset to 14. Tunisia not happy. Referee's going to have to check that one. The ball did not hit the ring, so it shouldn't have been reset here to 14 seconds. So the referees need to talk about this one. Discussions still going on between the officials, the referees and the table officials, as you see the Tunisians conferring there. The question is, did the ball hit the ring? That's what the officials are asking, saying if the ball hit the ring, then the shot clock is right. It should be at 14 seconds, and that is what they've agreed. So it remains at 14. Egypt will have it. Marai, low post. A lot of room to go against Mejri. Not an easy task. And Mejri fouls him and he's going to get the score. For the first time, Marai has won that battle there. Managed to move Salah Mejri out the way. Mejri tried to stand firm but wasn't straight. And that's where the foul is called. If you look, Mejri, good position, but there you see the arms come down. It's always going to be a foul, an easy call for the official. So Marai, chance to add the bonus here. 6 points for him. Tunisia, you know, they've played well. They've had just a superb performance from Salah Mejri so far as well, but they only lead by three. I expected a close one coming in, but it just feels like Tunisia, you know, have been by far the more superior team in the early stages here in this first half. And the scoreboard doesn't really reflect that as it becomes a two-point game. Egypt doing well to hang on, well to stay around here. Roll, attacks, stops, fires. In and out for Michael Roll. And Egypt a chance to tie or take the lead with a three. Amin off the high screen from Marai. He's got a lot of room. Takes the jumper, bounces a couple of times, doesn't go. Nobody timed the rebound particularly well, but it goes out in favor of Tunisia. Players will head to the benches then as we've got a timeout called here. 3:22 left in the first half. It's a two-point game. Tunisia leading 29-27 over Egypt. And it's the Tunisians that will talk it over. That's the difference in this second quarter. Egypt recovered well. 14-8, they have the advantage in this period. And as we said, you know, for Tunisia, you just feel like they've played far better than the scoreboard reflects. Just the irresistible play of Salah Mejri, 17 points and 8 rebounds. Not really had anybody else helping him. You know, Ben Ramdan, just 2 points. Michael Roll yet to score as well for Tunisia. The only other real person that's contributed in a major way is Omar Rabadu, who has 8 points. And for Tunisia, you know, outside of Abada and Salah Mejri, there's only 4 points scored by the other players combined. And that shows you. We did mention the fact that in round number one of this World Cup qualification, Tunisia struggled mightily for offense. I'm not sure he hasn't, but everybody else on the Tunisian team kind of has. See what Tunisia look for coming out of the timeout. Meshadi has been so good, you'd expect him to be involved, but then will they try to get somebody else going as Ben Ramdan perhaps gets away with the travel, finds Meshadi. That'll be two more. Salah Meshadi lays it up. He moves to 19 points in this first half alone. Now Egypt go to their big man, Marai. Draws a double team, kicks it, Amin for three, doesn't get it. The crowd cheer here in Tunisia. Oh, a steal, great anticipation. And the finish, an easy one for Omar Farak. Great work from him, cuts the lead again. Ben Ramdan looking around, gives it to Michael Roll. Roll. Comes off the screen, draws the switch against Marai, beats him off the one dribble pull-up, and there is Michael Roll off the mark. What an addition he is to this Tunisian team. His friendship with Salah Mejri goes way back as well, as Egypt managed to regain the turnover. Marai fouled on his way to the basket. Two shots to come here. Michael Roll got himself off the mark. I mentioned his friendship with Salah Mejri. He's committing a foul. It goes all the way back to the Antwerp Giants in 2011. And these two players play together. It was the start of a relationship that sees Michael Roll turning out for Tunisia. So, another timeout here. Let's head to the benches. 33-29 game. It's actually been called as an unsportsmanlike foul on Michael Roll. So upgraded. After we come out here, it'll be two shots and then possession for Egypt. And what an opportunity this is for them. Coach Roy Rana will have a chance to draw something up. He'll organize his team here, tell them exactly what he wants for their possession. Under 2 minutes left in the first half, and they have a chance to tie it up here if they can make the free throws and then make add a field goal as well. Here's the steal and finish. Amin getting an easy two for Egypt. And it's been about their defence in this second quarter. They've held Tunisia to just 12 points. The one thing they haven't been able to slow down is that man there, Salem Ejeli. So, unsportsmanlike foul. Madai will shoot two here. Madai steadies himself. 7 points, made his only free throw. Nothing but string on that one. Chance to make it a 2-point game again. Awesome. Madai spent his formative years in the US, college basketball in Minnesota. At the Division II level, just one of two for him on that occasion. But still, it's a one-possession game. And a chance for Egypt here with the sideline possession. Under 2 minutes left in the first half. Mahmoud back in, hands it off. Rolls to the basket. They're going to get a clean look at the three. Could have tied it. But bounce is clear and Abada says, let's slow this down. Organises things for his team. Now Mabrouk to Michael Roll. Roll to Ben Ramdan. Gets it back again. Roll has the step. His pull-up just comes up short. And Egypt looking to run. Abdul Halim wants the screen. Madai comes to set it. Abdul Halim snakes off it. Gets to the lane. Wasn't the quickest of moves for Abdul Halim, but he knew exactly what he was doing. Got his man on his back, went off the glass for two, and it's a one-point game here. Now Mabrouk holds and waits for Abada. We'll hit 1 minute left in this first half here. A tight game, as we expected, between these two North African rivals. Ben Ramdan for three, too strong. Easy rebound for Egypt, a chance for them to take the lead now. It is Abdul Halim with the ball. Forced to his right hand, falls to the floor, but manages to kick it out. And then we've got a technical foul, and who's it going to be against? It's against Salem Ejeli. So Ejeli called for the technical foul for a simulation. The Tunisian player's not happy. Ejeli with a look of astonishment on his face. He will go out here, Meshri. Just a chance to cool down. And Egypt will have a free throw and then possession. Replay so far. One shot to come. Abdul Halim from the line steadies himself. That's a beautiful stroke, isn't it? He has picture-perfect form. As he makes it. And now it's a sideline possession. We are tied at 33. 36 seconds left. Mahmoud collects the pass. Drives on Ben Ramdan. He's trying to be physical with him. He gets the steal. Roll collects it. Michael Roll. Just take some air out of the ball here, taking his time. And letting the clock wind down. Holding and waiting. Now he'll call for the screen to be set. Gayaza sets it. Roll, trying to find some room. The clock down to two. Moves it on to Abada. He doesn't get it away in time, though. He makes the shot, but it's waved away. So that one's not going to count for Abada. 5.3 seconds remains for Egypt to take the lead here at the end of the first half. Well, the back-to-back AfroBasket champions struggling in this second quarter. Abdul Halim takes a couple of dribbles, just trying to find some room for the heave. Sells the pass, but doesn't get away in time. So we are tied at 33. What a first half of action this has been. There it is. Egypt 33, Tunisia 33 at the half. Wow, it looked like Tunisia were going to be comfortable in the first quarter. Using that superb play for Salah Mejri, they opened up a lead. Looked like the Tunisia of old, but Egypt, with the quality in that front court they have dragged themselves back into this game. They lead it in the rebounding. And they've used a balanced scoring effort. They see Amin with 8, Marai with 8, Abdul Halim with 6. And for Tunisia, you know, it is only Abada and Mejri that have really done anything for them in that first 20 minutes offensively. So here we see some of those highlights. Egypt jumped out to a 7-0 start and then just went ice cold. It looked like Tunisia were going to run away with it. You know, we said that Tunisia have dominated this matchup the last couple of years. But back came Egypt in that second quarter, despite some superb play from this man here, Salah Mejri. What a first half from him. He has dominated at both ends of the floor. He has 19 points on 8 of 13 shooting. He's got 9 rebounds as well, but he has picked up 3 fouls with that late technical at the end of the first half. So that is the one way to slow him down, have him on the bench in foul trouble. Egypt kept plugging away, kept doing their thing. You know, had a front line that we've referred to, Mahmoud and Madai, combined for 12 points and 10 rebounds. They have played their part. And this is going to be set up to be a good second half of action here in FIBA Basketball World Cup qualifying. Egypt with the 5-1 record coming into this game. Coming into this Group F encounter. Tunisia already lost twice, both times to South Sudan. In Group B, they will not want to pick up a third defeat. This is a team that does not lose here at home in Tunisia. They've not been defeated since 2015 on home soil. Right now, they are in a dogfight against Egypt as we are tied 33 apiece at the half.
When the moment arrives and you're carrying the expectations of an entire nation, representing your people and their dreams, the colorful faces in the streets, the screaming fans in the stands. It's time to make your move. All eyes on you, all hope, all heart. Because when you win for all.
Throws up the alley-oop. Ah, here we go. Well, it was a slow start for Angola.
And another turnover leads to an alley-oop dunk. Great pass, nice finish by that man, number 4, Sanehe.
Kone will bring it back the other way. Drives full speed, and there's the follow put back. That's a big play by Sidibe. And Dukba drives it, gets rejected by Eddie Tavares, and there's no foul on that one, baby.
Uh-huh. South Sudanese basketball right now. Everything about this game.
Nice give and go. Good back cut there by Salamiri.
Iroku throws it. Throw down! Metu on the backdoor play. That is beautiful by design, and no one caught Metu coming in. Upon Kaluma. Oh, what a move! Shape to throw it down, and in midair, changed it to an underhand layup. And a steal. And what a move! What a play from Abdul Rahman. The steal on the inbounds.
We'll be right back.
Half-time here as Egypt face off against Tunisia, 33 apiece. A tied game. We expected a tight one between these two North African powerhouses. The back-to-back Afrobasket champions, Tunisia, opened up an early lead, but they were pulled back in that second period as Egypt won it 20-12. The Tunisian offense, which had struggled in round number one of this qualification, looked so smooth in the first 10 minutes, fell apart again in that second quarter. So now, which Tunisia will we see in the second half? Will it be the free-flowing offense involving Salem Ejri and with other players coming to the forefront, or will it be the disjointed effort that we saw in that second period? Ejri, three fouls. And if he was to head to the bench, it would really worry the Tunisian offense. He has 19 of their 33 points at the half. So the Tunisian fans looking on as we are ready to get underway in the second half. Welcome back to Tunisia then. Second half action. Egypt and Tunisia battling it out here in Group F of FIBA Basketball World Cup qualification. First possession, a turnover. Good defense from Ben Ramdan. And now Abada. There's a spot for Salem Ejri in the starting five in the second half. There's the five for Tunisia. Abada, Shanoufi, El Moubrouk, Ben Ramdan, and Salem Ejri. Ejri does have three fouls as Ben Ramdan draws the contact. Anas Mahmoud picks up the personal. He's out there with Abdul Halim, Farag Marai, and Shihata. For Tunisia, this may be the man that they look to get him going. In this second half, as Akrem Ben Ramdan has been a superb servant for this Tunisian team. The Afrobasket MVP in 2021 as he helped him win for the second straight time. The three is up and good. There's a knockdown from Egypt. Farag making it. And Egypt have the lead here. 36 plays 34. Coach Bauman, not a happy man. Rightly so on that side. So a bad up. Trying to make something happen. Switching defense here from Egypt. Kick out. Shanoufi. Too strong. Abada, the only man there for the rebound. He's still open on this near side, but El Moubrouk holding and waiting. El Moubrouk controlling it. Taking a long time. Takes a tough three. Misses again. But another offensive rebound for Tunisia. Ben Ramdan keeps it alive. Now El Moubrouk has the step. Loses it. Egypt running. Got numbers down the floor. Amin goes up high. It's rejected by Ejri. But a basket is given. A basket. Goaltend by Salem Ejri as he looks around, berating his teammates, I believe. He is not a happy man. Oh, was it the call that he doesn't like? Ejri, if you remember, has already picked up a technical foul. Got to be careful here. Tough to see on that angle. But Egypt now have a four-point lead. They had a 5-0 start to the game. Ben Ramdan in the low block. Sells a couple of fakes. Marai holding firm, but then he fouls him. First foul against Asamadai. Line possession. El Mubarak to Ben Ramdan. Now Abada. There's a little bit of room. Abada takes his jumper. He's short. Good offensive rebound. That's becoming a problem for Egypt right now, giving up a lot of offensive rebounds. And Mejdi is fouled on his way to the rim. Yeah, that's a clear call. That is something as well as Egypt have done here. It's now 8 offensive rebounds for Tunisia. Shots to come for Salem Ejri. 19 points for him. First, though, comes up short. Former Real Madrid big man. Can't hit either. Another offensive rebound. Ben Ramdan can't finish, though. Well, offensive rebounds almost every possession right now. Egypt have got to take that challenge. Tunisia really have lifted the physicality here. Amin kicks it out. Mahmoud spins, falls, and a foul is called. Well, a lot of complaining from Tunisia here. A foul is called against Ben Ramdan. You can see the Tunisian players are not happy. And I don't think that Bauman can be described as happy either. He's got to get his players to focus on this game. Rather than chasing down the official there, you can see, you know, the coaching staff having to come onto the floor to pull their players back. And then Salem Ejri has been called for the technical foul. Rightly so as well. That is number 4 on Salem Ejri. But the second technical foul means he has been disqualified now from this game. And we said it is emotional character. What a loss that is. 19 points, 9 rebounds for Salem Ejri, and he has now had to leave this game. It's going to be free throws to come for Egypt. They've got a 4-point advantage. They're going to have some free throws. So a technical foul has been called. Let's confirm that it is against Salem Ejri. Still, the discussions continue. Coach Bauman has managed to control his team. It's a 4-point lead here. Oh, a lot of drama. He's going to go to the monitor. So let's have a look here, see if we can recap this one. Mahmoud spins. Well, there's it. There is a trip. No, Ben Ramdan, the left foot comes out. Mejdi, incensed, wants to travel. He didn't get it. I don't think it's the worst call. And you can see Ben Ramdan wisely goes to the side, first of all, removes himself. And then he comes back and he's got words with the referee as well. One thing that has done is ignited this Tunisian crowd. here we see it again. So there it is, there's the trip. I think that's the right call. The left foot definitely moves from Ben Rahm down, whether it's intentional or not. And you can see the technical foul being issued clearly against Salem Eshri. And then the complaints continue. Eshri frustrated with his bench. Before the complaints towards the officials. You can see Meshki in the background giving the daggers. Apologies if you can lip read. I don't think that was hard to see his disgust. Well, after some drama, we'll be back to free throws here. The first misses. So, a host of substitutions for both teams. We'll get to that later, but Salem Eshri was adjudged a technical foul. Ali misses both. Ben Rahm-Dahn also committed a technical foul. So that's why we've got the two free throws, as well as the personal foul on Ben Rahm-Dahn. So Meshri has gone. He has been ejected with the two technicals. He leaves the game 19 points, 9 rebounds, 2 blocks in 18 minutes. Ben Rahm-Dahn now has 3 personal fouls. That's something for us to look at. And then, to get back to the game, Egypt have a 4-point lead and possession. They go to Marai. Marai on the inside. Well, it's a smaller lineup now for Tunisia without Salem Eshri out there. And Marai has the chance to really take advantage of that in and around the paint. He's got double digits now. 10 for him. Ben Rahm-Dahn. Mihani trying to find some room to Abada. Abada throws it up high. Can't finish. Another offensive rebound, though, for Tunisia. And Egypt just can't get a rebound right now. Abada makes them pay. Ties the game, or makes it a 3-point game, 40-37. You can see some life in this Tunisian team, even though their, you know, backs against the wall. It's almost inspired them. You can see the energy they were playing with before the ejection. Abada knocking down the three. He's going to have to take even more of a role now. Omar Abada, 11 points. Now it's complaints on the other side. Mitrana, he's unhappy. So Abada, Amin, off the screen. Takes the long three, doesn't get it at this time. It's Tunisia that can't grab in the rebound. So that's Toumi in his first action. He came in after the scuffled incident with Meshri. Marai goes out. Surely a short blow for him. Mahmoud squaring up, puts it on the floor, kick out from him. Abdul Halim trying to find some space, just 7 on the clock now. Easy shot and another offensive rebound. Yet again, Egypt will keep it alive. Eventually though, Abada takes it away. Oh, look at the hustle. Great defense there. Who was that on the floor? Abdul Halim, a diving save. Took away a certain 2 points. Roll, nice little pass, Ben Ramdan. Oh, he can't finish again. Ben Ramdan, just one of six from the field now, 3 points for him. With no Meshri, he has to be the guy to get going. There's another turnover against Egypt. Their offense has fallen apart as well. Abada fouled. Fourth team foul against Egypt. He'll be sideline possession. You know, feel like this game is there for both teams. Someone's just got to take it and get control. Tunisia, can they channel that frustration? Maybe feeling right now. Roll has it deflected, collects it in the backcourt. Okay to continue. Shot clock still at 14, so plenty of time. He looks to go to Ben Ramdan, but a poor pass, turned over. Neither team able to score here. Amin trying to find some room. Gives it up to Shusha. Now the high screen. Switching defense. They'll give the three and Amin knocks it down. And if you're going to switch, you've got to take away the shot. I don't know, the scout there. It's a 6-point Egyptian lead. Nice passing from Tunisia, but it can't find a big opening until eventually it gets to roll. He's not ready for it. One more, and somehow it goes for Tunisia. That is Toumi. Both teams struggling for quality. Mahmoud moves and on, and then finds the pass to the inside. A missed attempt at the ring. It's time for Egypt as Tunisia will come the other way. Abada makes himself some room to take the three. Misses badly. Shusha with the rebound. Let's get the ball over the half here. Amin just beat the 8-second count. He's in no hurry. Comes off the screen. A lot of contact. Gets deep in the lane. Loses it. Bodies everywhere. It's out of bounds. It will be in favour of Egypt because Abada, as he took it away, was out of bounds. Coach Bauman, look at the sweat on his jersey. Shows you how hard he's working. Love the effort from Abada there. He takes a blow. Coach Liam Flynn in the background looking on for the Tunisian staff. Coach Roy Rana. Mm-hmm. 39, plays 43 here. 6 seconds on the clock. Another stoppage while we make sure the floor is properly cleaned. Get it in. Oh, there was an opening there. Mamou missed him. That makes the play. So drives to the basket. Smart from him. Another foul against Tunisia. They're fourth now. Still an end line possession. Plays 39. Another whistle. Referee's really trying to get hold of this one. Another whistles from them away from the ball. Mahmoud with the score at the other end. He's only got 6 points, but 5 rebounds, 3 assists for him. Shusha there. Looking on. Fouls against Egypt, so 2 shots for Makrem Ben Ramdan. So this is a man, you know, the current AfroBasket MVP. The awards that he has won throughout his career. First team All-Basketball Africa League in 2021. African Champions Cup winner MVP of the African Champions Cup as well. And now he plays his club basketball for Benfica in Portugal, where he helped them to the Portuguese League Championship this past season as well. He's a man of great quality and somebody his team is going to need right now as they are going to get the stop on defense. It is Ben Ramdan. Himself down. Ganuni handling the ball at the point. Trying to find some room. They go once more to Ben Ramdan on the low block. Ben Ramdan can't finish. And it's going to be possession to Egypt. Madai fired up. Rightly so. Great D from him. Roy Rana looking comfortable on that sideline. Surely the confidence growing for Egypt here. You know, you take away that first quarter that they lost 21-13, and it's a 32-19 lead for them across the second and third so far. Now a chance to build it even more. Once more, they want Murray on the post. And they don't need him as the three is hit. He could barely see the ring there, but the lefty, Shahata, knocking it down. His second three of the game. Egypt open it to an 8-point advantage. El Mabrouk off the screen. Ben Ramdan goes hard at the ring. Yeah, blocking foul. It was too easy from Youssef Shahata going down onto the floor. There he is. Shahata just made the three at one end. And picks up the personal foul. Two more shots to come from Ben Ramdan. Went one of two last time. Misses that one. It has not been a night to remember. A legend such as Nakamura Randan. 4 points for him now, 1 of 7 from the field. Misses a pair. Does have 7 rebounds and 4 assists. Mahmoud playing off the dribble. Wants the cuts to happen. They do. As now Farag finds Murray on the roll, loses it, chance to run. Tunisia have to slow it down because Egypt do a tremendous job in defensive transition. And then an offensive foul. Gayaza picks up another one. That's at least the second illegal screen that he's set. Bada's going to have to come back for Tunisia here. They wanted to give him a break. Farag with the ball then. He's in no rush. They'll keep feeding. Murray has caused a load of problems in that low block. Of course, no Meshri on the floor. It's not really a great matchup to slow him down without Salameshi. Changing the backcourt for Egypt then. And Michael Roll back onto the floor for Tunisia. Murray faces a double. But a strong drive and finish is good for Ali. Great work from him. Egypt just getting, you know, contributions from all over. Everybody seems to step up. Everybody making a play for them right now, and they've got the double-digit lead. 50 plays 40. Largest lead of the game for Egypt as a foul is committed. Mabruk shooting the three. Trana just encouraging Youssef Shusha. So this will be three foul shots to come. Good. Three for three for El Mabruk. .138 left. Egypt. Comfortable against pressure. And Amin is in the game. Here he is. You have him in. Just as I said, they're going to commit the turnover against the pressure. It's because Amin wasn't involved. Murray has some confusion as he tried to get it over to Shihada. And who will be the man that goes out? Shihada. Bada. And now El Mabruk coming off the high screen. Gets to the lane. It's a poor pass out. Murray behind the back. He's got numbers. Just manages to find his target. The extra pass. But what a recovery. Murray stays with it. He's fouled. And he's going to get the roll as well. Well, that is Egypt today just working, continuing to play. And even when it wasn't going their way, they just carried on going. They will not be denied. Eventually, it gets into the hands of Murray, and it's rightfully so. There's the steal. He just manages to get it on. The extra pass is rejected, but Murray is there with the finish and the foul. and get the chance to add this one and stretch out this lead. He gets it to go. Awesome, Morai. Makes it a 10-point game. Inside the final minute of the third period, Roll. Can he get going for Tunisia? Twelmer Mabrouk. Now Roll gets it again on the low block. Hangs, fades, comes up short. And Egypt seem to have now solved their problems on the defensive glass. They cross the half. They'll use some time here. Amin in no hurry. Pulls it out again with 25 seconds on the game clock. A foul. Looks like a clash of heads. Who's the foul going to go against? Murray? No one seems to know who the foul's on. Called against El Mabrouk. Team fouls means this will be two shots to come for Marai. So Marai, chance to make it a 12-point game here. What an opportunity heading into the fourth period this could be. Murai steadying himself. 13 points. And that one away short, on rebound away from a double-double. He's also plus 16 when he has been on the floor. Shows you the impact he has. Second. Also misses. And Ben Ramdan grabs in the rebound. Another chance for Tunisia. Can they capitalize? Can they somehow dent this lead that Egypt have? Abada off the screen. Abada gets to the lane, draws a lot of contact. No pass. Here comes Amin. He's a tough cover in the open floor. Amin fouled and will shoot two shots. Omar Brook picks up another personal as well. It's going to be number three on him. We have Amin slow to get up. It seems to be okay. So quick in transition, isn't he? Amin. Yeah, just the arms for Omar Brook. They're not straight up. That's where the foul was called. So there'll be two shots here. Barely any time remaining. Trahana organising his team. Doesn't want any fouls to be committed. Pulls everybody back. So it's not even challenge for the rebound here. Another miss though. Three in a row they've missed from the line. Points for Amin. Second is good for him. And Tunisia won't get a shot away in time. That is the end of the third period. It's another great quarter if you're an Egypt fan, because they have the lead right now, 54 to 43 over Tunisia. We said their second and third quarter dominated by Egypt, 41 to 22 across those two periods. Well, this is where champions are made, the back-to-back Afrobasket champions, Tunisia. Backs against the wall right here. They trail by 11 at home to Egypt. Remember, this is a Tunisian team. There's been a force at home. A 15-game streak for them. Unbeaten here in Tunisia. You've got to go all the way back to the 2015 semi-finals of the FIBA Afrobasket to find their last loss in Tunisia. But Egypt have played well out here. And Tunisia have got to get a spark, have got to get something going. First possession, not a bad one for them. They'll get two shots here. Can Fidas Lelani get himself off the mark? Just look down, the players on the floor for Tunisia. Abada, Ben Ramdan, Shanoufi, El Mabrouk, and Lelani. The problem for them, Abada 11, Ben Ramdan 4. Shanoufi yet to score. Lelani trying to get his first point here. El Mabrouk 5. You look at the combination of Ben Ramdan and El Mabrouk. 1 for 12 from the field between those two. Lelani can be that X factor. He's a man who can score, but even he fails to convert. Both his free throws, makes just one of two. And the lead remains at double digits. Egypt have Amin, Ali, Said, Farag and Mahmoud out there on the floor. They're getting a rest for Marai. Foul is called and it's an offensive. There he is, that man again, Lelani. Mahmoud has got to go out, picking up his third. Travel against El Mabrouk. Sees it go back to Egypt then. Well, the one positive for them is time is ticking away here. Madai back onto the floor. Moves it back to Amin. He's a good shooter. Can't get that one. Great rebound, Lelani. Ben Ramdan now. Screens for El Mabrouk. El Mabrouk into the lane. Good feed. Ben Ramdan finally gets himself an easy one. I haven't said that too many times here today. 6 points for him now. There's plenty of time for Tunisia. This isn't a deficit they can't overcome with 8.5 minutes still remaining. They need to get stops on this end of the floor to give themselves a chance, though. Amin to the inside. Madai, kick out. Clean look for three. Strong. Madai collects it. He fails to convert, though. Well, there's a stop. It wasn't great defense from Tunisia, but it doesn't matter. They all count as a steal. Amin, ahead of the pack, goes with the left, lays it up for two. And El Mabrouk tried to, you know, put on a ball handling display in front of Ihab Amin, and that is the dangerous idea. Abada collects it. To Ben Ramdan, bullies his way to the basket. Can't finish, wanted a foul. Didn't get the call. Oh, lovely no-look pass. It's gonna be an easy finish for Egypt. And right now, Ihab Amin pulling all the strings. He gets the score in transition. Lovely little no-look pass for him. And here we go, Egypt building this lead more and more. It is 58-46. There's Mabrouk, his pocket picked. Amin, the beautiful left-handed finish. And then we'll probably see him as the passer as well on that last possession. Tunisia with work to do. Just 10 two-point field goals on the game for Tunisia. Remember, they scored 21 points in the opening quarter. And since that point, they have only scored 25. Points hard to come by. Elmer Brook with the ball. Abada. It's him and Ben Ramdan in the two-man game. High ball screen. Eventually kick it out. Shanoufi can't hit the three. Great work from Elmer Brook to keep it alive. Abada thought about it. Finds Elmer Brook in the corner. He'll take the contested three. Another miss from him. But another offensive rebound. The one danger really for Egypt, the way they haven't been able to control that defensive rebounding. It's amazing that Tunisia only have 46 points really, with the way that they've struggled, Egypt, in that particular category. 12 offensive rebounds for the Tunisians. They're bringing it from the end line. No, they won't. They'll bring it in from the sideline. Abada walks over. Here's Roll. Back to Abada. Abada gets the defender in the air. No call. Two on one in transition. Amin has it taken away. Good hands from Roll. Technical foul is called. Looks like it's gone against Egypt. No, it's against Abada. It's the number four for Egypt that was assessed a technical foul. That is, he had Amin, not Omar Abada. So basket is good, 1 point. As Michael Roll makes it, gives it back to Tunisia then. Abada being well guarded, finds Roll. So Ben Ramdan didn't even look at the basket from the free throw line. Elmer Brook wide open on this near side. Abada's pull up, short. The follow, also short. That's summed up the night so far for Tunisia. Great work. They got a good look for Abada. He missed it. And then an even better opportunity on the offensive rebound. It also failed to drop. Mahmoud finds a little backdoor cut. And the easy layup is good for Fadag. Ben Ramdan comes up short. Another offensive rebound. Leilani is good. Another three from Amin. Doesn't go. Again, time is their friend right now. Tunisia need a run. They need some momentum. That could help. No, Abada decides against it. Omar Brook now. Nihani will take it. And he buries it. Well, that's going to get the crowd into it. Is it a glimmer of life for Tunisia? A big three. It's an 8-point game. Still 5 minutes plus change left in this one. And we said, you know, Firas Aliahani is a man who can put points on the board. He's got 6 points in his 15 minutes. But you can't give Mahmoud that much room. He is fouled on his way to the basket. Now, when he caught the ball, it's just a wide open lane from the elbow. There's no way he's not going to score or be fouled there. Too much help being played. Second foul against Liani. Egypt's just making those changes, just keeping things fresh. No doubt, making sure they've got a good defensive team on the floor. Youssef Choucher especially has come in. He's known for his defense. Mahmoud now at the line. Yeah, that's Mahmoud, played his younger years at the University of Louisville. Makes that one. He spent 4 years there between 2014-2018. That was after a time at West Oaks Academy in Florida as well. Plays his career for Zamalek. Team in Egypt. So it is Abada handling the ball. Nice little fake and go. Ihani fouled. Can get two shots here. Well, he is shown to be a man that can make a play. That's just what Tunisia need. Attacking the basket again. Shots here. And wait for Hani to wipe himself down before he takes these two free throws. First gets the roll. Tunisia as a team, 12 of 19 from the free throw line now. Ihani, 2 of 3 himself. And he's known for his 3 on 3 career as well as 5 on 5. Second is good. It's a 7-point game. Keep saying it, but they're still there, aren't they, Tunisia? They're putting pressure up the floor now. This is a tough man to pressure, though. I mean, when he has the ball in his hands, he looks comfortable. Surely they'll look to, for him to give it up if they can. He's going to take the quick one. I'm not sure that's the types of shot Egypt are going to be looking for. Less than 10 seconds into the shot clock, a high degree of difficulty as well. So possession back with Tunisia. How interested would this become if Michael Roll can free himself for a three here? It's a 7-point game. Tunisia finally leading a quarter. They've been dominated in the second and third. And Rondon gives it up. Abada comes for the play. Deflected out of bounds. It looked like they were trying to go to the inside to feed Ihani. Abada to Roll. Roll will use the screen from Ben Rondon. Roll along the baseline, lays it up for two. Well, it's not a three, but he'll take the layup. Bauman still looking frustrated. His team alive, though. They trail by 5, 4 minutes left. This is where the home crowd can really help them. Bring that energy. Some good defense there for Ganouni. Osman gives it up. Tough drive. Finish doesn't go. Fight for the rebound. Mardai gets it. Can't get it to go. Ben Rondon snatches it in. Here comes Tunisia. Roll. Says he wants a ball screen. Ben Rondon comes to set it. Roll. Dances. Beats his man. Kicks it. The drive. Misses everything. Ganouni has it taken away. Amin looking to push. Ball goes out of bounds. The Tunisian fans want an offensive foul. They won't get it. It will be sideline possession for Egypt here. Timeout called. Both teams need to just settle just a little. 3:18 left. We'll see Amin trying to get it and go. Will be their ball out of bounds, leading by 5. Chips making their way back out. Tunisia still. Lots of words for them. They need some energy. They need a couple of big plays. Tunisia get themselves back into this one. There it is. The double-double. Osman Mardai, 13 points, 11 rebounds. He's been able to increase his influence since Salah Mejri went out. Amin holding and waiting. Now looking for Mardai. Amin somehow finds some room on his way to the basket. Lays it up for 2. Lynch Bauman is going to call a quick timeout here. Well, the play was not for Amin, but he saw the opportunity. He took it. And that is an all-important score. Just a little bit more breathing room again for Egypt with 3:05 left. Tunisian fans still in voice. Michael Roll late to come out. Here he is attacking the rim on that last reverse. Just 5 points for Roll. Abada has it. Can they get him going? Can they find some room for Abada? Cuts through to the corner. Roll. Has some space. Fires and makes the 3. Both feet were behind the line. 3 points is good. And it's a 4-point game. Still 2:45 left. Egypt not looking comfortable with the lead right now. Abdul Halim nearly loses it. Just manages to throw it off Abada out of bounds. But they haven't looked comfortable, have they? Egypt playing with this advantage. Couple of quick scores. As Ben Rondon, I think, is asking for the net to be removed from being caught. 12 seconds only on the shot clock here for Egypt. This is the man they want the ball with. Amin trying to make some room. Has the switch. Again, attacks hard. Can't finish though. Rory grabs in the rebound. And here comes Tunisia. Chance to make it a one-possession game. Abada waits for Roll. Just get the ball back into his hands. It's going to be the same play. Al Mubarak comes to the wing. Roll high. And then two-man game with Ben Ramdan. Roll. 5 seconds. Against the switch. Has the advantage. The little pull-up is good. Michael Roll back-to-back. He pulls Tunisia now within 2 points. Egypt gone cold when they didn't need to, and then Ben Ramdan knocks it away, but it's going to be Egypt ball. So close to a steal. Great anticipation from Ben Ramdan. Substitutions coming in for Egypt. Abdul-Halim goes out. You have to settle here, Egypt. They still have the lead. Under 2 minutes left in this one. High ball screen. Amin will take the three. Murai open for the rebound underneath. Can he collect it? He can. Murai surrounded by bodies, but it doesn't matter. He gives the gun show as he gets it to go. Murai makes it a four-point game. 90 seconds left now. Again, Roll has it. They're using him for every possession. Thought about the three. Now Ben Ramdan has the mismatch. Liahani steps through. Rejected. Mahmoud got it. Amin trying to push. And it's going to be a turnover. Well, expected the foul, didn't he? Amin played for the foul to be called. Let's have another look. There's the rejection. Amin tries to beat his man. I don't think Abada did get it. .109 left. 4-point game. Abada waits for Michael Roll. But it's Al Mubarak that comes. Al Mubarak with 10 on the clock. Liahani now drives. And an offensive foul. It's an offensive foul. The extended forearm is the call from the official. Liahani asking for the flop. Believes the contact went down too easy. 50 seconds left. Still, the game is on the line. It's only a four-point game. It's only a four-point advantage for Egypt. But they may well be able to seal it with a basket here. Tunisia could have come with pressure. Egypt do nearly turn it over, but now they'll settle. Kecherana on the sideline calling out the play. Amin goes to the step back and buries it. Amin knocks down the tough jumper. And that, could it be enough to seal this one for Egypt? There it is. Amin steps back. I mean, it's a tough shot. There was still time on the clock, but it went. And that's all that matters right now, because Egypt have got the six-point lead. Hadeb Amin moves to 18 points personal. He is the leading scorer for Egypt. Tunisia will advance the ball here. They can go for a quick three. Still 29 seconds to go. But the problem for them is, you know, who's going to make the three? Surely it's going to be something for Michael Roll. If not him, then Abada perhaps, or Al Mubarak. Most important thing for Tunisia right now, they must score, and it must be relatively quickly. So it can be a three, ideally. It could be a two, but they just need to put the ball in the basket, set their defense. Tunisia. Roll collects it, uses the high screen. Roll. He's up to Niahani. He attacks. Goes high off the glass, misses. He will immediately foul. Like we said, they needed the basket. That one doesn't go. They've got fouls to give here now. Tunisia, they've got to commit another one yet, I think, before he'll be shots. Egypt can play keep away here. They don't want to turn it over, but any time they can take off this clock will be an advantage. See Coach Bauman telling his team they've got a foul here. Called by Egypt. They have the opportunity to advance the ball into the front court if they show desire there. Make sure they don't have any turnovers underneath their own basket. Interesting dilemma for Coach Rana. Yeah, he's going to advance it. So he'll bring it in from the sideline. It means they'll, you know, lose the advantage of being able to play for the final shot, but you've got to expect that Tunisia will come with a foul. If they don't, 4 seconds will not be enough to make up the 6-point deficit. They must get the ball in safely. Play knowing that they'll be fouled. Make their free throws here. Thing is, they'll advance the ball, but with fouls to give, Egypt will run their play to get the ball in bounds, and it will still be sideline possession. Can Tunisia read what's going to happen, and then on the second occasion get a 5-second violation? Will it be two different plays drawn up for Egypt that they can remember here? Let's have a look. So they line up. That comes off three screens. Do get it inbounds. No fouls. Nothing called. Time running out. A foul is called. Whoa. Wasn't called quickly, was it? It's now 14 fouls. So, was it 5 seconds ran off the clock? Will Egypt go back to the same play? Can Tunisia get a 5-second violation here? They need it to try and win this one. Eventually get it back. The three from Roll doesn't go, and it is a famous victory for Egypt. What a performance from them. They take this one here. It is Egypt 67, Tunisia 61. Well, the 15-game streak for Tunisia here at home comes to an end. And Egypt, good for their victory, of course. The Tunisians will look to the ejection of Salem Eshri after he was having such a great game. There's a big disappointment. But, you know, Egypt, they played well during that second and third quarter. And they will continue with their fine performances in qualification for the FIBA Basketball World Cup. Some smiles from Egypt, but the work continues for them. This is just game day one of three games back-to-back here in Tunisia for them. So they will have their eyes on those games and really try and finish off this qualification window with success. Here are the numbers. A 35% two-point shooting from Tunisia, the downfall really. And despite the fact they dominated on the offensive glass, still Egypt were able to win the rebounding battle. Some of the plays from the second half then. An entertaining game. Egypt dominated that third quarter, 21-10. And they were led, you know, by that man there. Walid Ali had a big score there, but the backcourt combo for them, for Farag and Ihab Amin, really did step up when they needed, alongside the consistent performance of Ossem Marai. 15 points, 13 rebounds in the end for Marai. And there he is on the steal as well, playing both ends of the floor for Tunisia. And I said that, you know, points in round one of qualification were hard to come by for them. It looked like that was a long distance memory as they started the game so brightly offensively. But really, it just dried up, just 22 points across the second and third quarters. And when you look down the numbers individually for them, Abada had 11. Michael Roll ended with 10, playing just 25 minutes. And then Salem Ejri, the 19 points, the real standout before he was ejected on his second technical. Outside of that, though, you know, the percentages just weren't good enough as they shot 33% as a team overall from the field. And look at the guys that we know have been there and done it before for this Tunisian team. Guys like Ben Ramdan, who was 2 of 10. Omar Abada, 3 of 10. Helmer Brook, 0 of 6 as well. Oh, a good victory for Egypt. All credit to them. We said they were good quality for their win after coming out of Group D with a 5-1 record. They'll continue to move forward here on this one. That makes it now 6 straight games for Egypt in qualification. They lost their opening game way back in February. And since then, they really are taking step-by-step performances to get better here. 4 Tunisia, who would have thought they would fall to their third defeat already in qualification. The game-sealing jumper there from Amin to send Tunisia to that third loss. And the question is there danger for them in getting one of these top three places? The results from today's games, Cameroon taking the victory over the Democratic Republic of Congo. And then stay with us here for South Sudan facing off against Senegal later on from Tunisia. Quick look. As Egypt move to 6-1, South Sudan will get a chance to leapfrog them. Tunisia still holding on to that third position. Tied with the same record as the Democratic Republic of Congo right now. For me, from Tunisia, it is Egypt victorious over Tunisia.